Hello students. In this lecture, we will be learning about concrete mixers. First, what is concrete? Concrete is a mixture of cement, sand, aggregate, and water. Due to its properties, it is exclusively used in construction industry. As we know that the concrete is best in compression. And so concrete is exclusively used in construction industry. Concrete mixing can be done manually or by the use of machines. But manual mixing is not that efficient on various grounds. Concrete mixers saves money, time, it's easy to use, convenient, consistent in quality and avoids human muscle pains. That is, the mixers or the automated mixers to get the concrete well graded, it saves our money. How it saves our money? The mass concreting when done, it needs humongous amount of your human power or the manpower. And thus, it needs a lot of money. When done analysis, the concrete mixers are found to be much economical. It saves time, as the human have some specific amount of output to do the work. It saves our time, and large amount of work can be done with the help of concrete mixers. It's easy to use, as the concreting process is a long process. It's efficient enough and user friendly. It is convenient to use where the humans can't do the work, and convenient enough because it is automated and much mechanized. Consistent quality. It gives a quality which is consistent in nature and there is no human error. Like sometimes the worker may mix a little bit of more water or less water. So it may lead to other quality issues. So in the concrete mixer, it is not so. Avoids human muscle pain. It is seen that the laborers face various amount of muscle pains due to this hectic work, and thus this can be avoided by the use of concrete mixers. Concrete mixer can be defined as the machine which can mix the concrete constituents, that is cement, sand, aggregate and water, mechanically and saves human efforts, time, money and are easy to use. Thus, it is better to have or better to opt for concrete mixer than the traditional human typed mixing. Now, what are the types of concrete mixers? There are three types of concrete mixers. One, batch mixer, which have some other subtypes, that is tilting drum mixer, non-tilting drum mixer, reversing drum mixer, pan type mixer. Second is continuous mixer, and the third is the transit mixer. Let's see the batch mixer. In this type of mixer, a given amount of concrete is produced one at a time. That is, in the practical session, we have a batch of 25 students, and that specific batch does a specific practical at a time. So we have batches for that. First batch, second batch, third batch, and so on. So how the batches are there? We have some specific amount of quantity and a specific amount of output, that is concrete, is obtained. In this all, the constituents are added as needed, mixed, and finally discharges. And thus the input and the output is fixed. The constituents, that is cement, sand, aggregate, water, is fixed, and the concrete what is obtained after the mixing is also fixed. It is further categorized as follows. One, tilting drum mixer. Second, non-tilting drum mixer. Third, reversing drum mixer. And fourth, pan type mixer. So the first is tilting drum mixer. As the name goes, the drum, that is the tilting drum, is used. In this, as the slide shows, there is a drum. This is the drum where we insert the constituents, cements and aggregate water. It has one single opening. This is the single opening. It is the upside down figure, the figure taken after the work has been done. Here, the material is inserted from the same opening and the discharge, that is the concrete, is also taken from the same opening. This part is the machine for the rotation and the number of rotation, stopping of the machine, toolbox or the machine parts. The mechanic work is done from this toolbox. This is the driver for the tilting process. Here the wheels are there for the proper locomotion from the side to side, and it is resting on a stand. These are the four stand where it is used for the proper stiffness to that mixer. So here we can see that we have single opening which can be used for inserting the items and removing the concrete after the mixing is done. The axis is vertical in nature. The axis of this drum is vertical in nature and it can be tilted down. So let's see, tilting drum mixer. In tilting drum mixer, the drum has one opening used for both input and output purpose. Once the material is added, it mixes and delivers out by the tilting it downwards. It is suitable for large size of aggregates also. Small size aggregates can be mixed and the large size aggregates can also be mixed. Here there are blades inside the drum for effective mixing, but the only disadvantage is the material may stick inside and thus needs proper cleaning after use. And this proper cleaning can be done by the simple logic, a simple work, that is, after the concreting is done, we just need to add some aggregates, add some water and rinse it. Again, run it like earlier type, and thus all the cementous material, all that the sticks, stick items can be removed off. So this is the tilting drum mixer. Second is non-tilting drum mixer. In the earlier, the axis was in vertical nature, the axis of the drum. Here the axis of the drum is horizontal in nature, like this. So what are the parts? Here, if we see, there are two openings. First is here for the entry of the material, and here the second for the output of the concrete. Here the materials can be added from the places like cement side aggregates. Here say cement can be added, from here the sand can be added, here the aggregate and the water from the suction pipes, and thus the chutes are used to enter the material. The blades are inside, which can, and complete system can be rotated. If rotation can be in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. The motors are fitted. It is resting on a some kind of stands, and this is the discharge chute to get the concrete outside. Here, the material inside can be obtained or dragged out by the help of the discharge chutes, or by reversing the flow of your, reversing the rotation of your drum. For example, we can, if we say that the drum is mixing in a clockwise direction, rotating on the horizontal axis in the clockwise direction to remove the material, we will be opposing the mixing process or the rotating process, that is in the anti-clockwise. Let's see, if it is rotating in this direction, it is in the, say, clockwise direction, so it will be rotating in this way. But if we want to remove the material, then we will reverse the process, and in the anti-clockwise rotation will be given to the drum, and all the material will be forced outside, and we will collect the concrete here from this discharge chute. So there are chutes for the insertion of material, mixing blades are there, rotation is horizontal in direction, and the discharge chutes are used for the concrete collection. So, non-tilting drum mixer. In non-tilting drum mixer, the mixer has two openings, one for pouring of the material and another for the discharge of concrete. Here, the mixer rotates about the horizontal axis and has blades within it. The concrete discharge is collected through the chute attached below or by reversing the rotation pattern of the mixer. That is, if the drum is rotating in the first in the clockwise direction, then we will reverse the rotation in the anti-clockwise direction, and all the material inside this drum will be forced outside and we will collect the concrete. So what is the reversing drum mixer? Reversing drum mixer specifically uses the reversing of the drum only. Here we have some components, and the items what are to be added are used or added by the hopper. This part is your hopper. Here the cement can be added, the sand can be added, and aggregates are added. This can be raised up by either by the ropes or by this kind of hydraulic jacks. This is the machine which tells the operator that how much volume or how much quantity of the cements and aggregate is added, and we can see everything from this display, and these buttons are used for the process. Here this is the toolbox for operating and maintenance. The water is added from the other part, from the upper part, and it has a suction motor which sucks the given amount of water, and proper water cement ratio and every quantity is mixed in a specific amount. Thus we get the required quality of concrete, and it is consistent in nature. This mixer is driven by these four wheels and can be having a firm base due to these stands. So how it works? Same. The material is added from this hopper. The drum rotates in clockwise direction. Then to get the material outside, it is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, and all the material is taken outside. So this is the reversing drum mixer. In the reversing drum mixer, also the mixer has two openings. First for pouring of the material and for the discharge of the concrete. Here also the mixer rotates about the horizontal axis and the blades within it. The concrete discharge is collected by reversal of mixer rotation pattern. That is, say for mixing of material, the mixer is rotating in a clockwise direction. Then to discharge the concrete, it will start rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, or a vice versa, either of the case. Here the material may be filled in the drum either manually or by the hoist. Students, these materials or these machineries have number of variants, city to city, state to state, country to country. All these mixers have various kind of your models. Like in the earlier case, here we have the hopper with separations. There may be another mixer which doesn't have these separations, like cement, sand, aggregate, everything is in different compartment. There may be a simple kind of mixer or the hopper which is uniform, that is only single partition is there. Or there may be another type of hopper which is not supported by this kind of hydraulic jacks, but by the simple your simple kind of ropes and all. Or you may be needed to use directly the labors to insert your material manually. This can be also there. So there are various kinds of your variants. Now this is a reversing mixture, so it has a lettering like RM 800. 800 is the 800 liter capacity. It is measured in liters, so it is a reversing type. So RM, if it is a non-tilting type, then it will be NT 800, NT 500, and so on. The number represents your capacity, and RM or NT represents your pattern of your mixer. So the material mixing can be assisted by use of weighing machines and pumps to suck and supply water into the drum. So we can have a number of variants, small amount of variations are done, and we can have that kind of mixers for use. Now the fourth type is pen type mixer. As the name says, this is the pen in which the mixing is done. This is a pen where the material is inserted and the rotation is done. Here also there are a number of variants into it. So let's see step by step. It is resting on a foam base. This is the drum and these are the pedals. These one, these two and these three. Three pedals are there. Now the first pattern is the elements are inserted, that is the constituent cements and aggregate water is added, and the rotation, the mixers, mixing process is done by the use of moving these pedals, and the pen is steady enough. Or in the second type, these pedals are steady and the pen is moving. Or the third, the pedals are also moving and the pen is also moving. Okay, I'll repeat it again. There are various versions of this pen type mixers. First, in which the pen is steady and the pedals are rotating. Second, the pedals are steady and the pen itself is moving. Or the third, both pedals and the pen is moving. So there are number of variants and number of things can be done. Here the number of pedals can also be changed, like single pedal or two pedal or three pedal and so on. The diameter generally varies between 3 feet to 6 feet, depending upon the capacity and the work that has to be done. And moreover, the output is firm and of finest quality among all the mixers, but it is not that worth, or that it is not that kind of quantity is not obtained from this with respect to other earlier mixers. So let's see. Pen type mixer. As the name suggests, the pen type mixer is circular pen for mixing. Here the pen has pedals which are used to thoroughly mix the material. It has three types. First, the pedals rotate about the vertical axis and the pen is steady. Second, the pedals are steady but the pen rotates. And in the third pattern, both pedals and pen rotate but in counter direction. Okay, so the pedals are also moving, the pen is also moving, but in opposite direction or in the same direction may be there. Depending, all these patterns can be changed and be constructed. The pedals rotating may be placed either centric or eccentric to the pen and may have more than one set of blades. So as we have seen earlier, these pedals may be eccentric to the axis of this pen. Like centric means it will be passing through the center, and eccentric means this one. This is the eccentric pad and this is the eccentric pad, away from the center, and this is the centric pedal. So eccentric pedals may be there, or the centric placed pedals may be there. In all types, the discharge is collected from the opening from the lower end, and quality of discharge, that is concrete, is of better quality with respect to drum type mixtures. Here, various pattern of pen type of mixers can be developed that we have seen earlier in this figure. So what is the second type of mixer? Continuous mixer. As the name says, in this, the material, that is cements and aggregate and water, are added on continuous basis, and the discharge is obtained on the continuous basis. In the earlier one, we took this specific amount of cement, sand, aggregate, water, and added it, mixed it, and the specific amount of output was obtained. But in this, the continuous mixing is there in the hopper, and we keep on mixing it, and the output is opted. Here there is no time lag as in the earlier case, but is continuous and used in mass concreting like dam sites, bridges, and say skyscrapers and high-rise buildings. Now this is the third type of mixer or the process, the transit mixer. As here are the silos, these are the silos. It is called silo. This is the cylindrical type of element, we can say. These all the things, say it has cement inside it, this may have some sand, and it may be having some kind of aggregates here. Everything is mixed step by step into this truck mounted your mixer. This is the mixer where actual mixing is done. It is resting on a truck. Every item is added here on a plant which is away from your site, and it is rotating, say, clockwise. And when we want to get the discharge or when we want to have the concrete on the site, then reversal of your this drum is done and we get the material discharged. It is resting on this truck, so it is also known as truck mixer also. This is very much useful when the site is small enough for the work to mix the concrete on the site, or when the large amount of concrete is required, there also this transit mixer or the truck mixer is used. Let's see. Transit mixer. Transit mixer is a system consisting of drum mounted over a truck which is used to mix the concrete when in transit, that is when in travel. Material is added at one place and it is mixed during the transportation, and when the or as soon as the truck reaches your the site, then it can be used for placing or casting of your construction work. Here the plant batches the material and fills the drum with it. On the way to the site, the drum rotates at the standard speed, making it ready to be placed. Here the standard size is about 20 to 30 rotations per minute, and it can be controlled as per the distance required, and the maximum distance is said to have about 20 kilometers from the plant. That is, the distance between the plant and site should be about 20 kilometers, and not more than 30 minutes of the travel is suggested. It is not suggested. Concrete produced so is called ready mixed concrete or truck mixed concrete. Change in direction of rotation of drum forces the material to get discharge from the lower end. Here also same process is there. The drum also has the blades into it, and the if the this your drum is moving in the clockwise direction, when the placing has to be done or the discharge of the concrete is to be done, then it has to be rotated in the opposite direction, and the chute is attached here, and it all the items can be taken out. So this was the transit mixer. So what we have learned? We have learned concrete mixer. It can be divided into categorized as batch mixer, continuous mixer, and transit mixer. In batch mixer, we have some specific amount of concrete obtained. It has four types. First is tilting drum, which can be tilted upside down and rotates about a vertical axis. In non-tilting drum, it has a horizontal axis. Rotation of the drum is about the horizontal axis. A chute is used, or the reversal of the drum is done. Reverse rotation of the drum is done. In reversing drum, the drum is rotating about the horizontal axis, and it has blades inside it. It either uses, it also has chute. Recommended is that the use of chute should be there, not to allow the free fall of their concrete. And the drum is reversed way, is the rotation of the drum is reversed so as to get the concrete outside. And pan type, it is also having number of variations, that is pedals, rotation pattern of the pedals and the rotation pattern of the pan is changed step by step and can be obtained. In the continuous mixer, materials continuously added in the large container hopper, and it is continuously mixed, and the continuous concrete is obtained, used specifically for mass construction, mass concreting. And in the transit mixer, it is used when the site is narrow or there is no provision of site concreting or site concrete mixing. The transit mixer is obtained. Also for a heavy construction work or a road construction, or where the site is not that big and the surrounding is very much pretty densely populated, the transit mixers are used. Every mixer needs to be maintained very well, and it lowers down the human efforts, and so we are opting the mixers. So that's it for this video. Thank you.